you so much. The one, the only iconic Björk. I hope you enjoyed her company as much as I did. Don't forget, you can listen to it again on BBC Sounds. Tell all your friends. This is BBC Radio 2 on BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 9 o'clock. This is Claire Runacres. The Treasury has rejected calls from Labour to abandon the economic plans set out by the Chancellor Kwasi Kwarteng last week. But the BBC has been told that government departments will be asked to identify possible spending cuts to help balance the budget. The Bank of England has said it will buy government debt to try to calm the financial markets. The Conservative MP for North Thanet, Sir Roger Gale, said Mr Kwarteng had taken a high-risk strategy and needed to set out more details to calm people's nerves.
What we need quite clearly now, not waiting until November, but immediately, is a very clear statement of the business plan so that everybody understands the sense of direction and so that the Chancellor is able to tell the House of Commons and the public what measures he will be taking to ensure that people can pay their mortgages, can meet their business costs, will not go bankrupt.
Europe's biggest gas producer, Norway, says it will deploy the military to protect its energy sites because of concerns that two major gas pipelines from Russia to the continent were sabotaged. Leaks have been found in Nord Stream 1 and 2. Latvia's Deputy Prime Minister, Artis Pabriks, said Russia was likely responsible and President Putin was testing European resilience.
He's trying to put a psychological pressure, economic pressure, military pressure, any type of pressure in order to divide the Western response and try to win something back in the war in Ukraine.
A BBC Panorama investigation has revealed what experts have described as a toxic culture at one of the UK's largest NHS-run mental health hospitals. Patients at the Edenfield Centre near Manchester were filmed by an undercover reporter being mocked, sworn at and held in small seclusion rooms for prolonged periods of time. The hospital says it has taken immediate action to protect patients. A police officer has been cleared of assaulting the retired footballer Dalian Atkinson prior to his death in Telford in 2016. Mary Ellen Betley Smith hit him three times with a baton while he was having a psychotic episode. Another officer, Benjamin